here is the national instrument, folk instrument of Sweden. It's called a Nyckelharpa. A Nyckelharpa, nickel in Swedish is keys, and that's what these are here. And harpa means a stringed instrument. So it's a keyed stringed instrument, or a keyed fiddle. It's got 16 strings, three of which I'll play. Well, four. One's low, and all it really does is excite any whales in the distance. The other three I'll play, and the notes change by pressing up on these tangents. Ringing on the Nyckelharpa, that's caused by a couple things. It's got a larger body than a fiddle, but also there's 12 strings underneath the Nyckelharpa. And these 12 strings are all tuned to a different key. So if I play an A note, then one of the strings underneath that's tuned to the key of A is going to vibrate sympathetically just based off the energy of the sound coming. It's a little bit like a Hardanger fiddle in that respect, or Eric's 12-string guitar. And yes, he did get the 12-string guitar because he's very competitive. I have more strings still. So until they make a 16 or 17-string guitar, he's just stuck. We'll play another tune for you, and then I'll tell you a little bit more about the history of the Nyckelharpa and how it relates to the different Scandinavian countries. So why don't we play a Finnish waltz? And this one is called Metsäkukkia. It means the woodland flowers.
Thank you.
Nyckelharpa was first depicted on a church in Sweden back in 1360 in Gotland, Sweden. And you can imagine if it was carved into a church building, it'd probably been around a little bit before then. Nyckelharpas on churches are frequently seen either painted or carved, and when they are on churches, they are always played by angels. When fiddles come into churches, those are always depicted as being played by the devils. The Nyckelharpa was also found in Finland and in Italy and in Germany, all between the 1400s and the 1600s. And it does predate the violin, and some minor adjustments were made around the turn of the century by a very important Nyckelharpa player named August Bolin. Before, it would only be able to be played in the key of C. And August said, "I really want to play with more people." So he changed it to become a chromatic instrument and added more buttons and knobs, really fancied it up a bit. So now we can play in different keys. This was a tune that was made famous by a Wisconsin fiddler. Wisconsin fiddler named Leonard Finseth was a fabulous fiddler. People originally attributed this tune to being Norwegian in origin, but in fact, it was made by August Bolin in Sweden around the 1900s. This was the waltz that we played for them. It's called Rapkalas.